Earl Mike Molloy. We're in the age of prohibition, and we're in New York City, and we've got a gang of criminals, and they hit on a scam. They thought, we'll get some drunks, we'll get them to sign life insurance forms, and then we'll just feed them so much alcohol that they'll die.
Had they never met Irish people before?
Is Misha Anthony Molloy. Beidir nach ninean tú nis mé, agus cinnte go neachnáid tú an fult bre a grúige seo, a chrá corn sam a gohir sa gúna ngáil breiste scór blin ó hain. Agus Misha, se Misha, a bhí mar chaptín orde. Uí mé dá chlíte an náise.
One smartly into the Molloy, the Donegal team captain.
Bí leagú trein mé. O henne le, bachuish braad a gorni duwe, gar Misha Molloy as tofajar doon. Could you go wakami sure?
So they then gave him drinks that were filled with turpentine, horse liniment, rat poison. They paid a cab driver $150 to knock him over. He turned up the next day looking for a drink.
Bin shin, ni hatho daddy me, ach scale an ahi irsha a estri.
Please. You don't need money, Molloy.
Just let him roll it, please.
I'll ask the boss. Hey, boss, Molloy is looking for more credit.
Who?
Molloy, he's one of the regulars.
Yeah, a regular pain in the ass.
Nair chula mis an scéal seo a dosach bar a bhí mar cinte go raibh bainte go mafia le sin an sort scéal a ton. Ach ní ró, is grá dhaoine a rinne dochar. Ag an am, bhí gantanas miltine airgead in nó áireach, mar sin bhí daoine i teacht a níos le scéimeanna le airgead í anú go gasta.
As I únar an tíbín Tony Marino, a hannig ar an smuitiú a dosach barra. Cursi an síl an intin a chárdia, an grósir Daniel Kreisberg, an tailagor Frank Pasca, agus thar an vár sa tíbín Joe Red Murphy.
This Molloy character? He's a prime candidate.
An gyfrú na blina nidig sikata, agus spal an spal a mór ag lúsgú Níor thóg sí mórn ar Marino, iad a bhealú ar tlí na hórchaide.
We'd be doing the world a favour, though.
Tá lán ó Luaig thart san ceantar an seo, san ard na raitha, Cilceara, agus ring mé a lán fesargan faoi míl ó Luaig, agus ní ró mórn ombra You know, I'm a beer, hard from Canter and Shaw. Ach, so now I'm here in a Cuya land, the near America. I was Cuya land, the clan Oluig, and America Foster on Canter and Shaw. I saw my hack sheath and Shaw, and that's your ogle was hoping me. We die for clan, their fad, Shaq Jarrer, Kerry Jennifer. Green of wine, we oct and clan in New Aurach. Rod Bronach, and America Kinshaw. Ach, so now I'm here. You're fussy. I can be in shock. Chain to Antalu, and you're in shock. Ach, na crick. Ach, na kira. Ach, ach, the snyakta. Fussy, yeah.
Ní fuss an American wakes a honig me fain, agus me og. Tak me slán ag jarher an ye jarher, ach zidig fagal na cladi shock. Tá an dáchas a súla an Amerikaach feici agam. Ach nílas agam an rón splán círna a súla meid Molloy.
Get out of here!
But I'm conscious of a visa ray tormask, you ve a dal collach. Margaro na hunery she been, a famu gan rehan na cadenish. And ye an lagtra ak na myoch and nijak fisa nai, hitch kajan and ye go dona sakar. August is omi uner she been, a ve exolar and yev methanol. Finam gro Molloy, a janu a craig runde, a shebini na karach.
I've often heard stories of the older generations talking about bathtub gin. I mean, what in God's name could you make to taste like gin in a bathtub? They did, they managed. Prohibition, when we talk about it, you have to look at it with a new set of eyes, given that the response to it was so quick and so overwhelming, like, we're just not gonna shut down, I'm sorry. Especially in New York, I mean, even the authorities turned a blind eye to many an establishment that just kept on functioning as if nothing had ever happened. Sure, they had to change the outward appearance, maybe sneak beer in through the back door, but business was as good as ever, if not better.
Brian, could you tell me what was on Michael Molloy's mind coming through Ellis Island?
It was probably a daunting task to arrive. I mean, just to come from the old world, to come to a city like New York, was astounding in so many ways. I mean, it takes my breath away just looking.
You're supposedly tough, durable character.
Well, as we now know, he was probably the nicest man you could have ever known, just falling on hard luck.
Chaith me hain sean mar amarcach a new aurach siars na octadi. Agus uder morta jiviondu, gur auk na gael la mafana kella agone. Mar sin, ta si dili a hirskins cindoi gur hishmalai o chul an tureda.
So, Mike, you really don't got nobody in the city?
Huh?
Well, like, family, friends?
No.
Yeah, well, you know you got family here, yeah?
It was a speakeasy owned by an Italian. So I don't know that Molloy found himself there by choice. It was just happened to be the place that was the closest and maybe didn't know who he was as well as the other places did. So he could establish his reputation all over again and move on to the next one when that one wore out.
So there's no real evidence that he had people belonging to him at all?
There's no real evidence of his arrival either. No records seem to indicate. I mean, you can find many Mike Molloys. It's just, which one is him?
Hey, Molloy. You got life in
the Ahenig password, Dina, Ella, Gumakka, Usoid, then Chef Shaw.
Sign it.
Viahinig Dochtur, Avexosta, Tastis of Hurtoiv, Honorograph Molloy, Marov, Agus Gravushe, Boss, the Forsi Nadurha. Viahinig Liadori, Agus Ain, Dean Elegamakoko, Usoid, Honan Shefcha of Intimach, Agus Hon Nachmer Sulend Lee Orha, Agus Yedayanov.
As some grieve a cuifi halaf, le ling raid dorga duglanahan spalamore. Agus vinyard ruddy could juggle that the yeelog as a yanach. The anahain, the narrative.
That's it. Yeah. There you go, that didn't hurt. Slant.
Jan, Jerem Guru feel in the crew in the Hamarki is a chocolate.
Oh, we should fear for her father in the war of Economson. The price on the Eshel or sale, Gahing Economson, on policy orchish, near the Tachdas, ach, Mila Gahia dollars to him. Economom shows an arrogant the land, the Shunila Nocturnus, Kayag Nushaska Mila dollar. Ni Anachidarigation, August to our rent to the Kerogina. The Spanish is told him Keho Ufos of Vincel de Gahangan, Grodison Trillinach, and Erich and Farsha Varu, Ladazay and Uwer, Hon and Maid Bjogsha Arigada Oil to a Phoenix.
Maybe not.
Where is he?
He's not here. He's busy at the
minute. Yeah, whatever.
Well, Holly Mabel of Washington, D.C. is stuck with Gravashi Gmechonsail and he's far in the world.
Hey, baby.
Tony. You gotta come upstairs.
Not now, baby.
Be right there to than the clown, the kidney here, Gravashi Bucht, or who's? Ach, Hitchy, Hushiahine, or Marino, because the Bishin and Gail Bavasa via Kiriev.
Not now, baby.
You gotta come upstairs.
I said not now.
Come
later.
On, Tony.
I said later.
Again.
I said get the hell out of here.
Tony, you can't speak to me like that.
Our friend Marino, a married man, had a girlfriend on the side and used her as his first scam victim.
Lauren Geerig, Hershel is Kafur and Arder, August Visha Surka, Ninaka Nod the World and Vertic Yachno.
He knew she was, you know, susceptible to drinking a little bit too much once in a while. Took advantage of maybe this will be like one of those once in a whiles. Had the insurance policy all ready to go and did away with her.
Darvishin and Eeg son. Hugshin is to his spragada a lady in the Varish tree being an East Yanni, nor a Hul Molloy stachsa she being against the ranks.
Probably didn't look back, and there would have been several more had our friend Mike not been the man he was.
1, 2, 3, 3!
Go, come on, Molloy! And Rodas Tauti Villa Januakuna, Hacht or Valach Le Molloy a Waru, Nach Mach Fini Herbi, Nach Mach Finish Herbi. Nach mach trauma erbi janta don harp, so doy nach mach auris an linje fuin doy for Shabbos.
An kiad iracht sel Molloy, yinder iracht an normal kadocha hurta. Vise shina an iracht mar fi ana ra ege Molloy den doch.
Tammy, a giri, a holy, Mishas and Karsha, Yam Hain. Nurnakwal Karja be, Chuglocker be, Muncher be, Harfadudium, Oxtranchery. Yeah, we were shunning that jugna. The field show, Hokulat vis, Food Shall, Feast Shall, Tatahi Ogamershend, Mehain. When you am buoy of yoga, you need to knock it off. Hossy Meshagall, I guess, Tommy Barry, Foster. If you didn't need a canic doll, do we see the canic there? I was talking about whole looter if you see the canic there, I can am here now. I guess, you huckle yum say, shouldn't I kill again am?
Irish Mike, my old friend. How you doing? Hey, see. How about some of the good stuff for our friend Mr. Molloy here? Yeah? Some of the good stuff?
No, the hep are in whiskey outside of their air, winning their trail as antifreeze.
Take this for the special customers.
That's for a gos antifreeze. Gamarok shatina lashtig de lahur chleg.
Salute.
Ach a gos Molloy, the volshin duch no, as durche gamarlish and duchsha, non whiskey of your hurt to go da, so dolche a maid. Antifreeze of your foil.
Yeah, here we go. This ought to do it.
As Kincha grow on Baklashaw, a dealer lishan dunya control ya.
It's good stuff, huh? Again!
I can make her mirror's leish of Ethan Arshaw. No, on the knuckle fifth and raya, like a huntsohori.
So did these guys know what they were doing then?
Nah, these guys were like the gang that couldn't shoot straight. They gave him plain, regular ethanol, alcohol, and gave him that ad lib, as much as he could possibly drink. And they said, okay, let's try giving him some methanol. Antifreeze in those days had a great deal of methanol in it. A tablespoon of methanol is enough to give you serious vision problems. And 100 mLs, which is a small juice glass, is the mean or the median amount you need to actually kill people. We know we'll kill people.
Slides.
These guys, they would prime him with regular alcohol for several drinks and then give him the methanol. What they didn't realize that by giving him the ethanol first, what they were doing was occupying all of the metabolic sites. And when they gave him the methanol couldn't get to these sites in the liver to do damage. And so it had to be excreted through the urine, through the kidney.
Won't this Irish bum ever die?
So they were pre-treating him with ethanol.
Why can't we just shoot him?
Ní hathog daddy bé, ag túma ladras, aciel yma gá húl féin. ...3804, 3rd Avenue, The Bronx. An lár an a ha-speak easy merino, thrá. Tá an lár an ish ar nóth fícal loha at a tarnia maha ag an gáhar. Béidir go bhul sin nárea, fin láitse, Harley, agus an tolc at a físká, agree an dunia dana. Agus na hícíochtaí argais fós a nuic ag an bacla, bhí an fáid ag breisiú orau. Ach sé morfí a hánig a réiteach, an nuamh a tholáthar dó a na bhéla.
Irish Mike, how special. Bon appetito.
An tríú íreachta dhéanadar ar Molloybachta varú ná dúsáididir sardíní lofa. Fuair de canaí sardíní is dag de riad de mufinéir feig seachtain mar sin, go ní gráid ar lofar fad, agus thugad ar dó é mar cheapra. Agus arís, bhí Molloy an na hásta agus dish an na caprí. Agus ní rion sé an damáiste dó.
Ailecod a bhí an Pascua ar náithe, mar sin hánach se na balí a fuair daoine bás a han lá. Agus chur se fear a fuair bás de bhair gur íse áisirí lofa, mar sin smuite se.
It was amazing what they fed him. I mean, oysters soaked in formaldehyde.
Agus é cinniúram teach ar task na tuairisc ar Molloy seo. Rí siúlam go mar dú dul sa tóir ar na hadalaí sa scéal. Agus ring mí cuine le héileacháirí a dálach le feicil an ru aon cáint ina measc siúd fin air seo nar bhéidir a chátha a ní.
I know the story because of my parents telling me, but I have somebody here that's about 86 years old. He's the oldest guy that I know that's left from the old East Harlem culture, and I'd like you to meet him. Come in. His name is Pat Guido, also known as Pat the Hat.
Hello, Pat.
This is Anthony. Yes. It's Pat.
Hello, Anthony. Pleased to meet you.
Yeah. I believe your father knew Frank Pasqua.
Very well.
Yeah, the Undertaker, yeah?
He was at my father's wedding. He was on the bridal party. So they had to be very close friends. And when this all happened, it obviously came out in the paper, and that's how my father became aware of his antics. Up to that time, I doubt if he knew what he was doing.
Yeah.
And he was a funeral director, but he was in dire straits. He wasn't making any money.
Yeah, he must have been stuck for cash, wasn't he?
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Needed somebody to do the burial. So they picked on him.
And what did all that stuff happening around that time, yeah?
A lot of things happened that time. It was the time of the Depression, everything. Yeah, happened.
So people are doing
people
anything for money.
To survive.
And it's a tragic story.
Yeah. It's all normal.
But it's not normal killing people, is it?
Like what?
Not normal killing people for money. But it probably was the norm, wasn't it?
I mean, it was desperate times and people would do anything for money, even kill other people.
Yeah. Sure.
I believe
however, you.
However,
you know, this man just wouldn't die. I mean, he was out of the ordinary.
That was the funny part of it.
Yeah. My parents told me that they ground up glass and put it in his drinks.
Yeah.
It still didn't affect
him. And then they had some tuna fish salad or something. They laid that out a couple of weeks and then he came and he devoured it.
Yeah. If you're writing an epitaph tomorrow about Michael Molloy, what did you write?
The man who couldn't be killed.
Very good. And you, Sal, yeah?
Funeral director's nightmare.
Vi Marino agolas a viaud, ni hoku lofa Molloy waru, mar sin smuitisha mai gilor. Maraha misha Molloy ar a doi cairna a warama Maybel Carson.
So they got him totally soused till he passed out. Took him out in the winter, I think it was January, out to a place where it was bitter cold, half stripped him, poured cold water on him, and left him there, drunk as a skunk, to theoretically freeze to death. Well, they look in the paper the next day. Where's Mike Molloy? He's not listed amongst dead bodies found. There's no unidentified dead bodies found. They can't find him.
Jesus, what happened to you?
You can see how this would have just been unfathomable to these guys to have seen this man's face walk in that door yet again. Ready to drink some more. Let's go. Where's that good stuff? Never mind that bad stuff.
According to legend, he said he had a wee chill. Just a wee chill. Anybody else would have been dead. But when I looked at the autopsy information on him, said he was a big fellow. Big fellow. I think he was 6 feet. And he weighed about 187 pounds or something like that. He was a huge fellow, so it would take a while for him to cool.
But the police found him, and he turned up the next day saying, "You'll never guess what happened. They found me in Central Park naked. I don't know how that happened, but they took me to a hostel, and I got me these nice new clothes." And so he carried on drinking, and they were really getting desperate.
a thampla an asúil é Molloy don éirneach alta. Stereotype a bhí go fór leahan nuair bhí féin a gobar a nú áireach. Tá tí nach ró Molloy a más colúdar gael eile a bhí titi fi smacht an dí.
Bhí timpel gohead míle éirnig den héad glúnan uára, sé nega degas a dje. Agus an sin hánig scota, bedar fehe míle sa blín ar in a fehedi. Agus lanchin a rai gudí nega deg trucca. Bhí achra ag tiocht ar héil agus ar ívá agus ar féin ívá an éirnach. Mar bhí na hérnig ag gairí sús, bhí dar ag genev aragat, agus dáma vrodeg ar meisgur é malai nur a hánig sé. Ní dóthe go mbeadh fáilte mór roimhe ag cuidbhádas na hÉirnigh sin. Ní raibh aon ceanglaige le hÉirnigh sa Bronx, fiú nuair a tháinig nuair a thuaidh sé go dtí an Bronx. Agus bhí sé ag cur síos leis na hiodálaigh seo, ní raibh teach aige, ní raibh ád cónaí aige, meisciúr mór a bhí ann, ar tharla sin an tagóide bhí ann ó tharla sé go Meiricá, nó an fear tagóide go bhí ann sular tháinig sé go Meiricá. Ní líos agan sin.
Tá mar chorbh a cinnte go raibh Molloy a Brach a Mór ar Joe Red Murphy.
Please!
Go leor don na himirce seo, bhí cuaí miltin aru. Bhí fear a bhar, bhí seo cosa le sagart. Is cóirlear a bhí ann, is cara a bhí ann, thug sé arad dífa, chuirid sé scéal a bhaile d'imeacht ar a ghaí orthu, bhaird siad aragad dó ar a chur dífa, chun duna báie. Bhí seo mar bidir an tain cara a bhí acu.
Patrick, go dtí a fuaite mar faoin ar seo míle a lúg?
Well, is casúil gur tháinig sé ag America thart fa 1860. Tháinig sé más a chas cuairte gur bus Co Donegal agus cé go bhfuil a litrú ar ainm Bagan defriúil an dóhfuil dainim héin litrí. Ach, tan tainim a lai le MAL a lóhái, réisan de cátí an tan seo, stóig ar erhi un tainim ar a hannig sé steach na tíriv. Ach, hegilis a chair seo bínta a cruai. Gis speciálta na trochadí, nes vi na dýni ínta bácht, agus ní ro obar a bíla fóil. Ní ro arigad a bíla, agus vi ar gíni a le steaha línta le RNL. Ní raibh más acu ar líní a bhí lág agus ar fhaiban acu. Bhí sé tún fearbáirt.
Ié, bhí an fearbáirt sin, ié.
Agus
bhí fhaiban
acu. Ní raibh duine bíga le cuidiú leis. Agus is dóigh de thairbhe go raibh sé an chóní ar na sraitithe, ní raibh más a bír.
Bhís agam ar fan na blínta go raibh fhaiban agam leis an áil. Níach am éon dóchar a bhí an deoch ag Deanú. Bhí mis an áit ínta gúgnach sa Deirú. Te bhí na cárde, chud is mó acu. Ach, a stóchar dan, bhí clán mai agam, agus dan ma clán am, agus te mi bíach fi sin, fúr mi cuidú an sin Alcoholics Anonymous, AA, agus te mi pártseach a sin go fáil, nes, Tá mé sácha trí blian in is, ach, you know, sleáinna mé a couple úr, ach, sa náam cíirna, ní ála ma nhú, tásach am sin, agus, tá mé mar cianar ar ma híl hén rís.
Gás éan den eile ar dáin, de bheith Molloy marav is féin talamh le mian uas. Bhí idir gairí anna mí aineach is dóilim, agus chuir idir an líle ar Carillo, Harry Hershey Green, gur bleis taxi, gan inach sé siúd iarracht Molloy a varú ar an stróid sa Bronx a lár na híhe. Mar gheall gur pátar a bhíon Molloy bhí sé non san hála a tráid. Is muid siad, OK, de lecú cara, ní bheith áras ar bífuí. the Homanche Tapiga Lord Nahiha Lorn Vohir Gwine Molloy Agus Vulshega Kruig Agus Vester Griffin Vertienta.
You get him, yeah? You get him?
Well, we're in Tadjaragar, Gerhani Polina, or Hivavala, Hog Polina, or Noihigina Horlana. Now we Jalarhan Bristige, I guess Karu Coupla Girim and the Hilm were for buying my cycle again. Ach, and ye couple of shachtin, we shall ask her a hand lame, see the Vargas gun daddy. Tas tadjer janter hebben ze boer en gesterter een rinch kassenle, garbontaste ton of alte, maar nur woolen kartu marschen die hannen het korp suus, marschen die janter een meisje kerne damaste, en gespidger gesen harle een gas Molloy.
Als die een van shaw, a korfalcher of Molloy gudien kahar, amorsjach shaw. Give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses, a dour chilish. Ach vi an van kierna abelda, a vi an a voistrus crua fosta.
Treat someone like a dog, he'll come back. He'll come back and bite you, and that's the fact, show. There you go. Dog.
I think we have to look at him as a survivor. He was almost indestructible and indomitable. I mean, what kind of spirit picks himself up from the frozen park, comes into a bar and says, I've had a wee chill. I mean, that is the kind of spirit that if that kind of strength and spirit had somehow been channeled more meaningfully, I think Mike Molloy could have led a happy life.
Tony Baston's looking for you. Will I tell him you're here? No, get rid of him.
Be tough Tony Bastoni, Margunya de Clinty Marino the Chibi. A cool girl scammer Bonnocku. After all, Shehan Kanye Ma.
He's not here, he's busy.
Get out of
here! Hey, Tony!
I'm done waiting.
What do you want me to do? I can't shoot the guy.
Og the Nish. We should look loved in action, Yehane.
It's getting to the stage. What's going to be him? What's going to be you, Tony?
It's cookie done. I don't deny.
And ye, ye, ella go magin ar an draulish. Ho Kreisberg agus Murphy Molloy go fada ye 1210 Fulton Avenue, the Bronx. Ach ar eiri leo fi iru, an ahach, da vil se seo a chlí.
So seo Fulton Avenue and so Anthony. So course nach den har the shane the blinte. Kerriscor being a special town the nish.
Oh harle and dun varu.
I guess it's course nach they still their faddy. Na mer vi on am an sanam shin. Ni a dalig na erdenig na gildig. A town saw hilly. A din of the von of Spain the sugar's legend than could you small nish.
So Sean Hatch.
Though you get deaf Fulton Avenue.
Yeah. Ni lagan Sean Hatch.
So, so, how do you know? I'm Donis.
Yeah. That's you, Nyok. The ball and washing shop.
Tan the Fergna Felix Shawlakanish, Aulus Gortroff and English of his game loyal hooth, as a one a car a giri muskelchinish. Yel arch on few, to half shamaloy, to like Fania, Sakar. Agus me ag magnu ar hiel Molloy. Vi is fustrach fui katia nar lorg se kudju. Kadid na joing a vi a karasto. Ta ogla vilchinach oram, nach ro kara ag es a tiel sio. Ach an dram a vi ag iri e a waru.
In the Molloy of a curra, egg Pasqua, or noye, jerry loff a ekir to wine, al o holocht, arahisha wine, ach, vin dara colocht, aurasach, we should get a corp Molloy ekel, I guess we should get a screwdo ear wash.
The kicker is, and this is why I say this is the gang that couldn't shoot straight, the kicker is, they didn't realize that carbon monoxide in blood is so stable that even if the body was decomposed, you'd be able to tell it was red. And you can see it in your tissue bottle. So the moment he came into the morgue, they would have made that diagnosis. Even when they dug him up several weeks later, one look and you say, uh-oh, I know what happened here. So then if you find a poison or a toxin, then you have to ask a lot of questions. You have to ask, who benefits from this death?
Vi han kan al drochro da tarant ir tibi nagas dunya dun na dini sio na Joe Maglioni. Na vi Joe inta morla tof Tony agus vi vartja gu giri ibru maca jain doi vi chid shkir dan taragad agus nil mat kinti gudira gudai harli bide gro farawanya kurtu bariacht, you know, grosha santach. Harley as ain't as etteru agus kevlinj. Sean rod journa of a year in the lad show na dún waru sa chibin, mar hursela sean chante lig sa chanter fa dúda gade Harley da Molloy.
You can't get five people to keep a secret. You're lucky if you can get two. If you want something to be secret, it must never cross your lips.
There go Joe Maglioni fui hún waru tough Tony renew plea bargain but a Harley in America gaminic agus there a fuir Joe Maglioni and plea bargain chrocha ahamlinie.
Turn around.
Let's go, Marino.
Rian scéal a mail an phobail. Dina Cainter, Ralph Lee, dúirt nuacht an a bhain gnach gur fisa gachtan is the Bronx miolach a dhaví tárlathe, seachas na Paulini.
Donald, de Warrell, gatíe a hip ar an scam seo?
Well, an rád a chur tús leis an scam ar dúis, ná an taint. Agus éag rád ar gíir tacht ar arigad, agus tréis tó bás a chóid, nuir chi nófaird, is hi an taint ar rís,
you know, this cast of characters, again, you have to put them in the background of the Depression and Prohibition. You had a dire economic condition in this country where people do absolutely anything outside their normal character to make a living. And, you know, it probably brought out the criminal element in a lot of people that it would not normally have done so.
Vi cas an láidir ag an inhúisibh mar ar nóithe bhí fine stát an isiacú agus an catarilla bhil hása siú do chuib milan ar a chéile agus a scéhú ar a chéile.
Thár is dó liomsa, nach hí an taint a bhain a bhí a dírú ar a gud aigne. Hasta gwaith an fear a varú ar a bhaile ar varú agus ar deire dhvíidir in an omíoch leo féin. An fear hóbo a chúr an cíoch. Agus an ceacht tá fáin o gíne, will look excel gacht in a dina.
As big sasso I'm fain a skelty jiltish. Ach vi skel Molloy in ye dolavim commotion on him. Nock sasso daddy me, och torus horse co prison sing sing. Ach a doll a warfary, and yoch jerry hame.
You wait, you want to die?
Yes.
We're getting close now to death here, right?
Yes, this is the back entrance to the condemned cell block where the executioner would come in to perform his duties.
Yeah. It'd be fairly scary, wouldn't it be?
That's a scary job.
I would imagine.
Old Sparky is the electric chair. It's a nickname that they gave it.
Yeah. Has it got a good name, all right? Old Sparky. Did it actually create sparks?
I'm sure it did. This is called a vocational building now, where the old condemned cell building was. This is the executioner's room. This is where the electric chair used to be. You might say in the finalizing it, Mike Molloy, after they tried to get him so many times, he might have won out. They fried the four of them in the electric chair, and Mike Molloy got his, you might say, his revenge on the three fellas that took his life.
Yeah. Is it a violent death?
I would think it's a violent death. It's electrocution. There's nothing's funny about that. It's serious business. So, Anthony, would you like to try a position where the old Sparky was?
Okay, I'd love to, yeah.
This is where the chair was.
Yeah. I'd love to.
There's nothing hooked up, trust me. You'll be okay. But this was 614 human beings sat in an electric chair, similar to the one that was in this area.
So when they turn on the current, what happens then?
Well, some of the chairs that were here do have some scratch marks in it, and I'm sure that the body would stiffen up, and you'd be grabbing the arms of that chair.
Probably gasping for life, really.
Yes.
Yeah. Or clutching
on. Once that hood goes over your head, it's not long after that where you'll be finished.
So tar ar scána a bhí mé an seo a New Europe. Seacar go raibh Molloy gan Gigeon, níl aon tuairisgéir sna déan aireamh, agus feictear tú nach dheobh mé amach a riamh cé as é sa seantíir. Agus é an imirceach a naithneid é Molloy. Taimh sé d'fhear a sheasúnt do na hanam éireannacha nach léigiú an nuireadh dóibh filiú ar an seanáit.
It often seemed to me like the more defenseless an individual was, that certain types of crimes were more common. I was constantly amazed by the evil in the hearts of men, of the terrible things that people would do to one another.
And do you think more at either New Orleans or Blackley, or either the Americanic or the Hernig, the true aura has a volume, does the Dini have a staunching? Need more on through as a tear show. Cobbis Dunya cut a horle in a hail. The location Dunya go make me to start cana.
I suspect that he, like many people who abuse alcohol profoundly, was very depressed, and that alcohol was his medication to feel better. No girlfriend, no job, no meaningful work. He was at the bottom, and there was no one to help him, and he was unable to help himself. He was ripe for the picking.
It all began when they took me from my home and put me on death row, a crime for which I'm totally innocent, you know.
Varti me torch fi irak de wanyella. Lorak Molloy sagahar a amshu. Ma vi ein kavanya levier. As a mass cost funcher in the strategy of Eoshe. Agus Kulame, Gros Gael Molloy, Agan Alientor, Agus America as Port Larica, Jim Power. Far a high shalk and Gigian, Sakar a Hain.
It's a tough city.
For the most part, it can be. After my time in Vietnam, I gravitated to here. If it wasn't for my time in the service, it would never have lasted here. I can share a little bit of probably the way Michael may have lived,
yeah,
because I have been homeless since a number of years after I got out of the service.
Jim, is Michael Molloy a part of the folklore of New York?
Well, I would think so for sure. Let's go take a look at this little spot over here.
Yeah, very good.
I'm sure there would be many a person like to have a gravestone up in an area like this.
I'd
talk
imagine.
About him forever, you know. This is going to be a little shock.
That's fantastic.
I think
yeah.
It's one of the nicer ones we did.
That's a great bit of work. I've been looking all over the city, tracing his whereabouts and what he'd done, but this is unbelievable to come here to this corner and actually see Michael Molloy in front of me here, the Rasputin of the Bronx.
Well, this is a definite tribute. Like I said, the Bowery is just down the road here. And in the hard times, you ended up on the Bowery. It's sad to see a good person come to a demise like this based on somebody's...
But this is a great memorial.
To take advantage of somebody.
This is a great memorial.
And it's a good spot. Yeah, look at the look on his face. I see him waking up going, let me have another drink.
This one's on the house as well.
You know what? You can rub him for good luck.
Yeah, you're right.
Right, Mike?
Ni far more karma me. Agus big omra tainish ar an garar skimadar agiri Molloy kona huvna shiri. Ach be kovnya go jo ar an Rasputin of the Bronx. Mar a Molloy as do vilcha a dardi jo kon na jeha and san gahar mor havja shaw.
Like a moth that tries to enter the bright eye, I go shuffling out of life just to hide in death a while. And anyway,
you know, when I think of Molloy, I think of indomitable, nearly indestructible, and you've just got to love him.
To be done with all this weighing of the truth, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth, and anyway I told the truth, and I'm...
Just took 2 minutes after that shock, and they were sent to meet the Mecca.
And in a way I'm hoping to be done with all this twisting of the truth, an eye for an eye and a tooth for...
Where's Molloy? If there's a heaven for drunks, he's up there telling jokes and mooching drinks.
And the mercy seat is glowing, and I think my head is smoking, and in a way I'm hoping to be done with all these looks of disbelief. A life for a life and a truth for a truth, and I've got nothing left to lose, and I'm not afraid to die. And the mercy seat is smoking, and I think my head is melting, and in a way that's helping to be done with all this twisting of the truth, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth, and anyway I told the truth, but I'm afraid I told